I'm going to share with you my entire SEO audit methodology step by step. Every step is going to have one video explaining exactly what it is about. Be ready for a very, very deep dive. So what is it like? What is this 400 step plus SEO audit checklist? So this is something I initially created in 2020 based on my already like 7+ years of experience in doing SEO and around 5 years of experience doing SEO auditing. And the initial checklist I created was like 200 something steps. And recently I started to review those steps. I was reviewing like Google documentation, all the things that now SEOs pay attention to, new things that have appeared, and I decided to extend it to make it like the most comprehensive checklist that is out there. And as a result, it is going to have around 400 plus steps. So this is going to be a really in-depth exercise sort of for you. And why so long? Why did I make it so long? So one reason is because I want this to be like the most comprehensive. So if you are going to do an audit, which is really that in-depth, you can be sure that this is the audit that will actually like change the game for the client. Of course, you will have to be paid for that accordingly, but that's something we'll be talking in different videos. And how do I want you to use it? And another reason why I made it so long is because this is the course about SEO auditing, and this course is supposed to teach you how to audit and how to audit in the way I do it, which is like super in-depth. So if you go through all those videos, if you practice each and every video, if you do a bunch of SEO audits this way, I'm pretty sure you will become one of the best SEO auditors out there. You will easily go to like top 5%, top 1% of SEO auditors. If you do it like consistently, if you like really put a lot of effort into doing that and actually like practicing the things I'm going to talk about. And this is super effective, both for the website you are going to audit with that, and both for yourself, because as I said many times, this is the depth no one really wants to go into, can go into, have time to go into. If you signed up for this course, you probably have time, you want to do it, you have motivation, so I'm pretty sure you will be able to do it. While updating this checklist, I was like looking for other tutorials, other checklists, other SEO audit guides on the internet to maybe look for things I have missed in my checklist. And to be honest, I reviewed a ton of things on the internet, and they were like maybe 2% of the depth I'm going to show you. I'm not saying that to make myself sound like the best. I'm definitely not the best, but I am definitely the person who likes to go into depth and detail and dissect everything. So it is not possible to find a checklist of that depth. Maybe you can buy one somewhere, but I haven't really found that. That's why we want to make it so long, why we want to make it so in depth, because this is what moves SEO needle, and this is what makes you a really, really effective SEO that people want to hire and want to pay premium prices for. So what can you expect to find in this 400 plus step checklist for auditing websites? Actually, I made sure that it contains basically any area of SEO you could take into account while auditing the website. This is definitely like the full in-depth audit methodology. So there are 14 main chapters in this SEO audit checklist, and each chapter will have a bunch of subchapters, and those subchapters will have like specific videos. Each subchapter may have like 5 videos, 5 steps. It may have 15, depending on the topic. The first chapter is SEO audit preparation, where I'm going to teach you about what you need to do, what steps you need to take while you are just preparing for the audit, because this is basically the foundation of your audit and of the success of your audit. Then I will tell you a little bit about how you can analyze the website's past, because you have to know about the website's past, because this may influence your recommendations and their effectiveness. Unless you are dealing with a brand new website, brand new domain, this isn't necessarily something you have to delve into, but in all other cases, this is. Then I will teach you about what data you need for an audit, from what tools, and exactly how to get it. And then we'll get into like more specific things. And I decided to divide the next steps into the stages in which Google search works. So this is crawling, rendering, indexing, and ranking. Some of the things you will find in those may belong to two categories, but in most cases, they can be easily assigned to either crawling or indexing, and so on and so forth. So in crawling, obviously, we'll talk about crawling, because unless the site is crawled, can be crawled, we cannot like move to any other further step. If Google doesn't crawl the site, we cannot even talk about rendering, we cannot talk about indexing, and we cannot talk about ranking. So crawling is like the fundamental thing for the website. So we're talking about crawling issues, what you need to do and know so that the website gets crawled, whether it is crawled correctly, and so on. Then we will talk about rendering, which is JavaScript SEO territory, but without that, without knowing that, checking that on the website, again, we cannot even talk about indexing correctly, or ranking. This is a crucial step I believe every audit should have, because it is not possible now, I think, to find websites which do not use JavaScript. Then we'll talk about indexing. You cannot really believe how many things you can put under that category. Checking indexation issues, checking other things that can influence indexing, like canonicals, redirects, no index tag. If no index tag is used correctly, whether Google can see the no index tag, a lot of things could be put into that. Then we'll move to serving, ranking, which is again, a ton of things can influence whether the site is ranked, how high it is ranked. So here we'll be talking about some factors that possibly are taking into account and influence ranking, and reviewing the website in terms of those. On-page SEO, I think, deserves a totally separate chapter. So we have a separate chapter about on-page SEO. Then, of course, EEAT, YMYL, basically any website now falls under that category. So we have to have that chapter as well. Local SEO, obviously, if the website has local presence, if it is a local business, we also need to check a few things here and there. I also decided to add accessibility as a smaller chapter, because this is also something that matters for SEO and for users. Then we have the entire chapter about Black Hat SEO, whether the site is using those tactics and whether they are working for it or not. And I may also share a few things here and there. Of course, an SEO audit cannot be complete without competitive analysis. So this is also something you have to look at. And the last but not least are quick SEO wins, which may be possible in the case of some SEO audits. And I will tell you what types of quick SEO wins are possible, how to find them, and how to approach this quick SEO wins kind of category, because you have to be careful with that. So that's more or less what you can expect. And in the next videos, I will start simply walking you through all those steps one by one.